What's up guys, welcome back to the channel. I'm really excited to bring you this video about Handheld Companion for your Steam Deck running Windows. This really helps with the Windows experience on deck, brings over some of those features we're used to over on Steam OS, and I just think makes the whole thing for Windows on deck a lot more viable, and this is a pretty essential piece of software. So we're gonna go over a lot in this video. I also wanna give huge shout outs to Benjamin LSR, Casper H, and DLL by Max K, among many others who have really contributed and worked on and made this happen for the Steam Deck out there. If you can support anybody, please do so. And all the links for everything we use today will be in the description below. All right, let's jump into it. All right, so first thing, here we are on our deck, and I've got Edge up with the website we need here for Handheld Companion. Again, everything in the description for you, a ton of great information on here for you, but we're just going to go ahead and grab the .exe here so that we can get it installed. Now, for me on Edge, you will get that little warning telling you that you need to approve finalizing the download. You may or may not have this happen to you, but if you do and you see this issue here, you didn't see it pop up in your browser, just go back, give it a check, and it's usually just asking you to go ahead and give permission to finish. So that's what I did here. No worries, no problem. I've been testing this for quite a few weeks and no problem trusting this. So I'll click Keep. I'll click Show More, Keep Anyway, and then it'll finish its download. And now we'll be ready to go ahead and install Handheld Companion. So let's get this minimized out of our way. We'll go back to our downloads here. I'll do a little refresh on the downloads folder. And now it'll show up proper here as it should. So I'm going to go ahead and click on this and run as administrator. That's how I prefer to go ahead and get it installed here. We'll click Yes. And the install process is very straightforward, no issues whatsoever, nothing special I needed to do, but I am just going to go ahead and speed us past it so we don't have to watch everything, but it's just your standard typical installation. It does take a few minutes as it does do DirectX and stuff like that, but I'll speed past to the end. Once HC is done installing, it will ask you to restart your deck so that you can open the software, so we'll do that now. We get restarted, and I've already opened HC, and here we go. Now, one thing is, I really love the UI. The layout of this is really easy to understand and figure out. So as you're learning HC, you shouldn't have much trouble. But we've got all of our options in here. We've got our controllers being emulated. We've got our Valve software Steam Deck controller right here being picked up. We can use the Xbox 360 controller or DualShock 4, which is really handy for PS5 or PS4 remote player cloud, which we'll take a look at cloud a little later. And another really important one for me is lizard mode for mouse and buttons. You'll use this on and off constantly when you're on Windows on deck. We used it on another software before, and it's really handy here. We're also going to bind that to some hotkeys, which I'll show you here in just a little bit. Now, if you go into settings, you can also control your auto start application. I prefer to start it myself, but you can auto start if you want, and you have light and dark modes and other things in here. You can do custom profiles. You can set up how your overlay is gonna look and react. That's gonna be our little pop-up menu that we're gonna also hit to a hotkey, and I'll show you that shortly as well. But a lot of customizing you can do in here, but I don't wanna get too much into that. I really wanna get into the nitty-gritty of how things are gonna work here. But you have these pins and hotkeys, and when you pin things, they're gonna show up in your quick access menu, which is really cool. So you can go through here and pick different things to pin. But to bring up that quick access or quick tool window, we're gonna go ahead and bind the three little quick access button on the Steam Deck. So I click that, and it actually binds that so that when we click on that button, we'll get our quick access menu, and we'll take more of a look at that here in just a little bit as well. I'm going to go through here and pin some more things that I want to show up in that menu, and you'll see those here shortly showing up when we bring that menu up as well. Now, the other thing is lizard mode again. So to make this really easy to turn on and off, you can either pin them, which will be fine. You could bring up your quick access menu and do it that way, or I've bound the two back buttons on the Steam Deck to actually work. So I click and bind for my mouse lizard mode here, and then I click and bind for the buttons one, and that gives me my two little clicks on the back of the Steam Deck there to actually toggle those on and off. And since I do use those on and off a lot, it helps. We also have the about page here. Again, shout out to everybody who has worked on this. Make sure you can support or donate or spread the word or anything you can do for this piece of software. Really, really great for Windows on deck. Now, I've hit the quick access menu on the Steam Deck, and you can see now we have our menu pop up here. These are the things that I pinned that I was showing you in the menu, so really easy to change these, pin different things that you want to, and then have quick access to certain items, including our brightness and our volume there also. Now, if we go over here to our little battery icon, we actually have our TDP limit right here. So very much like you would over on your Steam Deck, you can get in here, or over on Steam OS, you can get in here and actually adjust and limit your TDP. Great for working on battery life and stuff. We'll probably test that more in the future. You can manually adjust your GPU clock as well, just like over on Steam OS. We have our resolutions here. I'm only outputting at 800p right now, and our refresh rate. So we're going to actually add some refresh rates here to make it more like the SteamOS options as well, and I'll show you that. And then you also have your performance bar here as well. All right, so this is all great stuff and accessible on the fly, but let's go ahead and install those custom refresh rates. Now, you do not want to be docked, so we're going to switch over here how we're recording, and you don't want to be running HD or anything. So these will be in the description for you as well, but we're going to grab the Steam Deck bin file with the refresh rates, and then we're going to go over here and we're going to download the CRU or custom resolutions utility. You may have used this utility or something like it in the past. So I'll go ahead and get both of these downloaded here and we'll be good to go. So I'll go to my downloads folder. I'm going to left click and extract the CRU application here so that we can run that. We'll do extract. And you might get a pop-up when you go to run this application. So we'll go ahead and click on it here. And it'll ask you for more permission. I'll click more info, click run anyway. And now the CRU application will open up for us. Now, once this is open, it's really easy to add that bin file we downloaded. We're just going to go down to the bottom here and click import. Once you do that, your files will pop up here. Just go to wherever you downloaded the bin file for Steam Deck. Mine is in downloads. So I'll click here. At the top here, you see that Steam Deck file. I'll go ahead and click that. And now it's been added to the CRU. All you have to do is click OK at this point. Once you do that, you can go ahead and open up HC and get everything going. I actually restarted my deck and then opened up HC. But here you can see we're going to go into our quick access menu. And over here to our refresh rate. And you'll see we now have the list and the coveted 40 FPS from the Steam Deck that we can now use here. And I'll show this working in a little bit here in the video as well. But that's how you add those custom refresh rates if you want to do that for this utility as well. All right, let's move over and launch some games from Steam and non-Steam games here, starting with Steam. And remember the lizard mode that we talked about so much in this video? We're going to disable that with our hotkeys on the back, because once Steam opens up, it's going to take control of the trackpads and work as a mouse. So as you can see here, Steam's opened up, it's taken over, and I can even use the trackpads to click if I want to. And the virtual controller is hidden or muted from Steam, so it doesn't realize it's there and still handles all the controls itself and works really, really well for the gaming. So when I get in here, all the controls are working well. I do want to point something out, the quick access menu where you push our button here that we bound that to. Sometimes that doesn't always want to pop up. I have to click the screen with my finger and then hit it, and then it works. And then I use my hotkeys on the back to enable lizard mode again, because Steam won't give me mouse control here. But as soon as I do that, I can get in, make the changes I want to make, then I can go back to the game and disable lizard mode again, and it works just fine. But this is just a little thing that happens from time to time, especially if HC's up and running a while, you might want to restart it. And they are aware of this, and I'm sure it will get straightened out. It's one of the very few little things I ran into. And now here you can see our other refresh rates as well. So I'm switching this over to 40 hertz from the 60 that the game was just running at. You may see some flicker on the screen there now, but now with the game's VSync on, we're locking to 40 FPS as it thinks we're at a 40 hertz here, and that works really, really well and is a nice feature, kind of carryover from SteamOS. So it's nice to be able to lock those refresh rates in and get a little bit more control over the game's performance and battery life as you're playing here on the deck. Actually, Windows 11 battery life is getting really good, especially with some tweaking here on the Steam Deck. All right, so let's go into an Xbox app game. I've re-enabled our lizard mode here so that I have mouse control again, because I have closed Steam. I recommend having Steam closed anytime you're running a non-Steam game. So we're going to go ahead and open up the Xbox app. And I've just jumped into Phantom Abyss here. Controls have worked great for any Xbox game, or really it'll work for Epic, EA, or any of those. We haven't seen any problems. So for non-Steam games working well, I can have my lizard mode enabled if I want to for mouse control. Regular controls are working great. For Steam games, lizard mode off or disabled, and then the controls work fine there. Now I do have an F11 bind here that I made to the back button there on the Steam Deck. I did this for Xbox Cloud Gaming specifically through the Xbox app. So if I load up this, you can see I have controller support right here in the app and everything, which is great. And we have lizard mode enabled still, just like the other Game Pass game we were just in. But now we're doing cloud. So I'm going to go ahead and go into Cloud Gaming and launch High on Life. And once I get in here, everything runs really great. Controls work great for me on cloud and with remote play. When I go to bring up the quick access menu in here, though, you'll see when I go to hit the button, nothing happens. And it's actually opening, but the Xbox app is forced to the foreground no matter what. So if I want to see that, I'm using my F11 bind on that back button I just showed you to go at a full screen. And then I can get into my quick access menu if I want, do what I need to do, and then go back. So I've just bound that F11 to that back button for going in and out of full screen for Xbox Cloud Gaming. So just an option for you there, a little workaround for that so you can still use your menu, but everything working great here when it comes to Xbox Cloud Gaming and the HC software. Now I want to move over and take a look at PlayStation Plus. So we're going to change our controller type in here to the DualShock 4. And amazingly, the app for PlayStation Plus now, which used to be PS Now, picks this up as a DualShock 4 controller just fine, which is a pretty good feat considering on regular desktop PCs, we're still battling to get controllers to work. Now here in Spider-Man, I've launched into Miles Morales and controls are working great in here. You'll notice I have to hit this button a few times and I actually had to enable and disable lizard mode before it popped up, but indeed it did eventually work and it does come up to the foreground as it should for the quick access menu, and then I can scroll around, do what I need to do, and then exit. So everything was fine there, just had to hit the buttons a few times and enable and disable lizard mode, but again, that little bit of stuff going on is some things that are getting smoothed out, and again, the only real issues or gripes I've had is just the quick access menu coming up or popping up when it should, giving little quirks there, and sometimes just a restart of the HC software is fine, but controls are working great in PS Now. I can even tap the trackpad to work like the touchpad on the PlayStation controller to bring up the menu as you're supposed to. And again, if you've tried this app on a regular PC, you know that without a PlayStation 4 controller, you do struggle to use PlayStation Plus cloud streaming on your PC. And your Steam button works as your PlayStation button there. So I think there's just a ton of potential with this software. I've really enjoyed testing it out and making this video and really messing around with a lot of different games and settings and seeing the controller support work so well, whether it be on local games, Steam or non-Steam, through cloud, even on GeForce Now and others are working well, or whether it be through remote streaming, which works great for the PlayStation 5 and Xbox Series consoles as well. I didn't want to show all of that in this video as it's already really long, but there was a lot to talk about, and I'll be diving more into this in future videos, I'm sure, especially as I'm testing more Windows games on deck moving forward. But I hope you found this video interesting and helpful. I'm really enjoying this software. Support these guys if you can. Thanks a lot for coming to watch the video as always, and I'll see you guys in the next one.